Welcome back, guys. Today I'm going to talk about infrastructure engineer. So if you don't know what it is, there are a lot of job openings for this new sector in technology, which is called infrastructure engineer. And I realize that a lot of people don't know about this because this is relatively new. Earlier, you used to call them like system admins or network engineers. But as companies grow and scale, their infrastructure becomes bigger and bigger. And that's why these companies are trying to look for someone who is good with infrastructure, and that is what infrastructure engineer is. So I'm going to break this video down into four sections. The first section would be introduction. What is an infrastructure engineer? The second section would be the responsibilities of an infrastructure engineer. The third would be what skills do you need to be good at this work? And the fourth one would be what you should focus on and how you can be successful being an infrastructure engineer. So let's get into the first section, which is introduction to an infrastructure engineer role. So here's the introduction to being an infrastructure engineer. Now, how do I know about this? Well, I worked as an infrastructure engineer right out of college, which was back in 2016. I had no idea what it is. I just got an internship at Citadel based on this role. And my manager actually gave me this title. And he basically said, you'd be looking after the infrastructure. And that's why you are the infrastructure engineer. At that time, I didn't know what it meant. I was just going with whatever he told me to do. But essentially, what it means is, you remember during COVID times when there were a lot of businesses that were shut down, but there were some essential businesses like the fire station or the police station or media or the gas companies or financial institutes that were continuously running even during lockdown. And they were running because they were termed as essential by the US government or any government, as a matter of fact. So like these companies, an infrastructure is essential to any company or any business. And the reason behind that is because you cannot have a company without an infrastructure. Now you can say that the infrastructure does not exist on ground, which means that you have servers on the cloud, which would be like AWS servers or Azure, Google Cloud, Rackspace, DigitalOcean. You could have used those services, but what you need to understand is these services are platform as a service. So they are providing you the platform. They are not going to do anything for you. In that case, where you rent out all the servers from a cloud provider, you still need an engineer to go in and architect your like whole infrastructure, or you need an engineer to run the infrastructure. And that is the role of an infrastructure engineer, which means that he can be running Linux servers, he can be running Windows servers, he can be looking after the networks, he can be looking after databases. So any component of the infrastructure is overlooked by the infrastructure engineer. And the main point over here is because an infrastructure engineer is looking after all the components of the infrastructure, he doesn't has to be specialized in any one of these components. It's good to have knowledge about database. So if you are a database engineer, you can become an infrastructure engineer and vice versa. But for being an infrastructure engineer, you need to have knowledge about all the components of infrastructure, which could be system admin, like Linux servers, Windows admin, which is like Windows servers, you're looking after Windows servers. You need to know about networks, storage, databases, and maybe like cloud services, like load balancers. You need to know about VPCs. You can know about like container systems like Docker or Kubernetes, or you also need to know about like virtual machines like VMware, Cisco UCS. So all these technologies, you need to have some kind of idea about this, because the infrastructure of any company would have these components. Every company will have a database, every company will have a network, and every company will have storage servers, and every company would have Linux or Windows servers. So as an infrastructure engineer, it is your role to monitor, administer, and troubleshoot any issues that come on the infrastructure. So that is what being an infrastructure engineer is. So let's go over the roles and responsibilities of being an infrastructure engineer. Being an infrastructure engineer means that you're overlooking the whole infrastructure of a company. So what are the roles and responsibilities of being an infrastructure engineer? So I covered a small portion of this in the last section, which is you need to be able to administer, troubleshoot, and also develop the infrastructure because you are the person who is responsible for it. So any issue arises on the network side, people are going to call you because for them, there's a problem in the infrastructure. They are seeing some latency, so they don't know what it is. So they are going to call and say that, hey, I'm trying to connect to this server and it's taking quite a lot of time, or it is lagging, or there's like disconnects. So they will give you a call and you need to understand what the issue is and who is the right person to contact. Which means that if someone calls you about latency issues, they are not going to say that, oh, there's latency issue. They are going to say that the connection is slower than usual. And then you should understand that there could be a latency issue or there could be like packet drops. So you need to engage the network team. So you need to have a basic idea of all the components, because if someone calls in and says that, hey, I'm trying to copy this file and it's taking way longer, or it's taking like 1 hour to copy something that usually takes like 30 minutes. So it could be a network issue or it could be a storage issue. So you will basically have the tools to troubleshoot. All the eyes would be on you because people are counting on you, because you would be the first person they will call because there's an issue with the infrastructure. So whom would you go to? You'll go to the infrastructure engineer. So basically the roles and responsibilities of an infrastructure engineer, if I could put it in one sentence, would be to administer, monitor, troubleshoot any infrastructure issues and escalate or resolve it as per your knowledge or as per your permission. So those are the roles and responsibilities of an infrastructure engineer. In the next section, we will look at what skills do you require to be good at this role. So what skill sets do you need to be a good infrastructure engineer? Well, like I mentioned earlier, there are several components of an infrastructure, and it is very unrealistic to expect someone to be very good with all of these components. And that's why if someone is good with networks, he's the network engineer. If someone is good with databases, they are going to be the database engineer. So when you come to an infrastructure engineer, you cannot expect them to have specialized knowledge in certain components, but you need to have a basic knowledge about all of these components. So the main skill set that you need for this role is going to be to become a jack of all trades and master of none. You don't need to go into deep dive with any one of these components. You need to know the basics of each of these components. The second skill set is to be good with Linux, because you will be troubleshooting a lot of server issues. You would run into problems with infrastructure that is related to servers. So you need to have a good understanding of Linux or Windows. But most of these servers are Linux because they are free. When you have Windows servers, you have to pay for license. So a lot of companies go with Linux servers. And then you need to have basic knowledge of at least networks, storage, and databases. When it comes to cloud technologies and containers and virtual machines, they are all part of servers. If you know databases, if you know storage, Windows and Linux servers, that is more than enough to get a job being an infrastructure engineer, because every company will have these components. After that, you can look into the smaller components, which would be like cloud technologies or containers. So I'll make a playlist on all of these components and what you should learn about these sections of infrastructure. And you need to be up to date with the current technologies. So I would say that you need to have the passion to learn new things, because if you stay stagnant, you're not going to be good at this job. So that's it for this section. The next section would be like how to be successful at this role and basically how to get a job being an infrastructure engineer. Well, now comes the question, how would you be successful in this role and how you can actually get a role like this? So let's start with how will you get a role like this. Now, every company that is growing will have an infrastructure. It's like an essential part of any business. So there's always going to be recruiters who are looking for infrastructure engineers. So the first thing you need to do is set your LinkedIn as an infrastructure engineer, so you show up on those searches. The second thing I would say is at least get a Red Hat certification or CCNA, like which is the Cisco Certified Network Administrator. Get one of these certifications, as it would be a big plus while the recruiters are looking for an infrastructure engineer. The third part I would say is reach out to other infrastructure engineers. Mostly you will see the title in other people's LinkedIn headline. So you need to just go and search for people who work as an infrastructure engineer and basically send them a message saying that you want to learn more about this role, you are passionate about technology, you have interest in all the domains, and if they are hiring for an intern or full-time, you'd be happy to help them with anything that they need. So reach out to all these people who are actually working as an infrastructure engineer. So that is how you will get a job being an infrastructure engineer. What does it take to be successful at this? So the main thing that I keep repeating is jack of all trades, master of none, because this is very crucial to this role, because you need to know what is going on in the infrastructure. So to succeed in this role, it is vital that you know where to look at and what you are trying to do. So troubleshooting skills is a must, because you'd be getting calls that wouldn't say much. They would just say that, hey, I'm not able to connect to this server, or I'm not able to connect to this network. And it's your responsibility to ask them the right questions. So that's another skill set that you'll need, is to ask the right questions right away, so you don't waste time troubleshooting or looking at the wrong things. The third thing I would say is what I mentioned in the last section. You should be able to handle stress, because this role expects you to know everything about the infrastructure. So that's a lot of stress, because people are reaching out to you thinking you are a person of authority. You know what the issue is, so you can't let them down. You need to be able to handle stress. And the fourth part I would say that is needed to be successful in this role is communication. If you can't communicate what the issue is, you are just going to delay the problem. So if someone calls in saying that, hey, I'm trying to connect to this network and I'm not able to get in, and you find out that the firewall ports are not open, then you need to be able to engage the network team and tell them exactly, hey, this user is trying to reach to this destination. It seems like they changed their external IP. We need to add a new IP in the firewall to allow this user to communicate with that service. So communication skills is a must. So to go back and summarize what you need to be successful at this role, the first one is jack of all trades, master of none. The second is you need to keep up with the new technologies. You should have a passion for learning. The third one is to handle stress. And the fourth one would be to communicate properly. So these are the things that is needed from an infrastructure engineer. I hope this was helpful, and I'll try to put in some resources. There is one component which is like system design, but I don't really think that is needed much for being an infrastructure engineer, because that is more like a solutions architect role. So I will still try to link all the resources that I think are helpful in the infrastructure of any company. So that's it for this video, guys. I'll make a playlist breaking down each and every components of this and how to prepare for these things to become a successful infrastructure engineer. So that's it for this video, guys. I'll see you guys in the next one.